See ya.
Thank you.
beacon of hope, a new beginning, a fresh start, a chance to change the world. With it comes the potential to be anything. He kākano koe, a seed filled to the brim with potential. The journey of life presents you with opportunities to flourish, but with your feet planted in two different worlds, being your authentic self is highly discouraged. Our transition into the Western world is assumed to be seamless and beneficial, but to try and succeed in a system that is not designed for us to thrive as Māori is fictional. 1769, the British arrived, colonised. 1840, the Treaty of Waitangi, not as advertised. 1863, NZ Settlement Act, legalised. 1867, Te Reo Māori was banned in schools, authorised. 1920s, Māori were relocated to the cities, urbanised. 1940s, most Māori had left their whenua for the big city life, patronised. 1975, Dame Fema Kupa, not one more acre, revolutionised. 2004, foreshore and seabed, scrutinised. 2007, Tūhoe raids, terrorised. 2022, only 5% of Aotearoa is owned by Māori. Tragically, unsurprised. Mum was right, Kōrō also said, people can be mean. Haere tonu, just keep going, ae I ōnu. Inside the womb, my mother was categorised as a young Māori girl who could fuck up a patu te Aotearoa o Ngāti Pākehā. She would see how Māori were traumatised, chastised and compromised, far from anything ever televised. Pākehā were disguised, standardised and unsupervised. She didn't feel comfortable in either set of eyes. When I was a child, I was told that life is black and white, but if you're black, you should try to be white, because white is right, right? Within many school systems, we are often seen as hopeless, hood rats, whores and hostile. Our names are butchered, Tama, Tama, Kaya, Kaya, Manaya, Manaya, Te Arakai, Te Ariki, Hine, Hineraukatauri. Traditions belittled and history left untold to break the mould you were put in before you took the breath of life. You must strive, thrive and pride yourself on how well you know their world. They're expecting the seed to flourish without anything to fertilise it. Being a minority on your own whenua, your own land, feeling as though you're playing the game of life with a single card in hand. No idea, fully confused, makes me want to scream. Haere tonu, just keep going, ae I ōnu. The overall goal in life is to make your world into a ngahere, not a forest. A forest is filled with pine trees that drop needles that kill the surrounding plants. A ngahere requires nutrients and space for the seed to reach its full potential, beyond expectation, to experience the full glory of Tama Nui Te Rā. You need interlocking roots and relationships with those around you, and a community of trees to lean on and keep you planted through every storm. And for us young Māori, the successes of great Rangatira, our expectations and heads must be held high. Rather than investing time into things that will lead to our demise, we must remember our ancestors who were wise, the resilient rangatira who carved messages into legends, proverbs and mōtia. We, as the iwi Māori, must encourage our whānau to do the same.
Forget the haters, kia kaha, reach for your dreams. Haere tonu, just keep going, ae I ōnu.
to be outspoken like Ibra Rickard and Wuramu Kingi Terangi Tāke, have a vision for the future like Tahimi Hinare and Tipuni O'Regan, create a sanctuary for those from near or far like Te Whiti and Tohu, innovative like Machu Rata and Apira Nangata, and unite our people like Te Puia Hirangi and Te Aotearoa Kāhu. This is the legacy I choose to remember. And with their blood coursing through our veins, our dreams and potential are the only things that remain. You're a tonga, precious and real, even a little teen. Ma is right, Pango is too. I believe in you.
Returns from beyond the veil to witness the birth of her uni, her descendant. She was given the name Hineraukatauri, a name passed down generations from the time when only the gods occupied the earth. The name of the Atua of music, the mystical and haunting sounds generated from nature's bounty and enabling a connection between the day and the night. Those of the flesh, and those of the spirit.
Oh, babe, she's beautiful.
Baby, oh, this baby, I can't believe she's here.
Mr. Skipworth, would you like to cut the cord?
That looks great.
Have you?
Yeah. Her name will be
Ko Hineraukatauri.
Hineraukatauri?
A Māori man?
Yeah.
Hineraukatauri, Katrina's got
there. Oh, Katrina after the auntie.
Nice, babe.
Go and get the whānau, babe. They'll be hanging out for me at the new audition.
Come on in, guys.
Oh, my moko. My first moko. Hello, my darling. Well done, you two. She's beautiful. What's her name, boy?
Hineraukatauri.
Pardon?
Hineraukatauri.
My great-grandmother's name.
Eh? Is it?
I don't remember talking to you about her, boy. Why her?
I don't know where it came from. It just came to me. She's 10 minutes old. She can't smile yet. All she can do is poo, cry, and drink.
But like you, really.
Cut it out.
All right, that's enough. Out you lot. My mind gives me a bit of rest.
Hey, see you, bro. Enjoy the screaming. And sing that piece. Bye, sis. Oh, hi, Hineraukatauri. Auntie loves you.
Oh,
I ever, me and Lance, we had a camper van and traveled down south. Oh, it was magic. And guess what? He asked me to marry him.
Oh my god, did you say yes?
Of course I did.
Sally, it's stunning.
So, when's the big day?
Next Jan, a garden wedding. Oh, I can't wait.
Oh, it sounds fab. So, you'll be Mrs.
No. I'll definitely be keeping my own name.
Why?
Because if I take his, I'd be Sally Tally.
You think that's her up name? Look at this one.
Oh, goodness. Now that's a tongue twister.
Tiny Row Country?
Yeah, sounds right.
I don't know why they give their kids names like this. She's gonna have to spend her whole life spelling it out.
I know. What's wrong with good old traditional names like Jane, Mary, or
Elizabeth?
Yeah,
it would definitely make life easier for everyone.
Anyways, I'm off for a coffee. You coming?
Oh, you betcha.
Hineraukatauri, come and get your breakfast.
Morena, mama. Morena, papa.
I can't believe it's this time already. Look at you, my baby. Such a beautiful young lady.
Oh, shush, mom.
Those boys better keep their asses to you, my darling. Well, papa will go and Bruce Lee on their asses.
Who?
You know, Bruce Lee.
Whoa! As you think, you shall become.
Dad, please don't embarrass me. It's my first day of CUDA.
Sorry, darling. Probably Mr. Cool Dad.
Mom,
he's just teasing my baby. I'll let the silly old bugger shame you out.
Yeah, you're older than me.
Maybe, but I look way younger.
What is this? Like on Papa Day?
Little Bridge Day.
You cheeky thing. No, you're ready for the senior. You go show those boys just how clever you are.
The following students are in 9EC class. Once I call the names, please follow Ms. Campbell to your floor class. Ms. Campbell, can you raise your hand, please? Thank you. Rhonda Smith, Anthony White, Raymond Jones, Shayla Williams, Derek Pop, H. Skipworth,
As Ms. Fellows said, I am Ms. Campbell, and when I say your name, please stand, say your name, your previous school, and some things that interest you. Rhonda?
Yeah, hi. My name's Rhonda. I went to Kinnikinna Primary, and I like anime and horses.
Thank you. Anthony?
I'm Anthony. I went to Rhonda yourself, and I like playing Fortnite.
Thank you, Anthony. Raymond?
My name's Raymond. I went to Kāpiti. I like sleeping and food.
Thank you, Raymond. Interesting hobbies. Shayla.
Hi, I'm Shayla. I'm at the beach. I like nipple and hip hop.
Thank you, Shayla. Derek.
Chat. My name's Derek, but you can call me Puffy D. I like girls, hashing, and Shayla.
You're such an egg. Anyways, we're related, Dick.
Okay, that's enough of that. Hineraukatauri?
My name is Hineraukatauri. I went to Paikākariki Primary. I like poetry, kapaka, and rugby.
Thank you.
Hineraukatauri. Oh my god, doesn't that just piss you off?
I have no idea. Miss, can I talk to you, please?
Yes.
Miss, my name is pronounced Hineraukatauri. Hineraukatauri. I can record it for you if you like.
Hineraukatauri? Is that right?
Not quite, miss.
No offense, but I think it's just too hard for me. I wasn't brought up learning to speak Maori. Can I just call you by your middle name, Katrina?
I'd prefer if you didn't, miss. My name comes from my ancestor. It's very important to me.
Do you have any idea how big a teacher's workload is? I think it's quite selfish of you to make such an unreasonable request and put unnecessary pressure on me. Today is your first day at college, and I must say, young lady, you're not making a very good impression. What did you say?
Nothing, miss.
I don't like your tone, young lady.
Well, I don't like yours.
You rude little girl. How dare you talk to me like that? Go to the principal immediately.
I will. And I'll tell him how you treated me, too.
After a place, Muriwai Beach, and there's Muriwai Marae, and it feels like they're disrespecting my own whenua when they say that. And then when I tell them my real name, they say, oh, like Muriwai Beach. It's like, how come you can pronounce the place, but you can't pronounce my name? Like, when it's a name, it's harder for you, but when it's like a place that you're familiar to, you're like, oh, Muriwai Beach. It's like, how come you couldn't do that 5 seconds ago? Sometimes it feels like you're the teacher because you feel like you have to teach them. Like, it just feels like.
But I don't think that they would like it if we mispronounced their name. And yeah. Then they get irritated. They get. Like, oh, sorry.
They're like, oh, that's disrespectful. Like, it's not that hard. It's like.
Most people don't really know how to pronounce it though, so that's kind of frustrating, I guess.
That's our last name, isn't it?
Yeah. P people usually, like, they don't really know how to pronounce the R's in Māori.
Yeah.
So they say, like, Wanikere or stuff like that.
Yeah, they either say, like, Anaru or Anaru, like, or Anaru. Like, yeah, it's kind of weird. Like, yeah.
Yeah, same as, I guess, people think it's easier to call me T. I mean, oh, it's chill. Like, I don't mind getting called T, but, yeah.
When it's your friends, it's not that bad. I guess, like, teachers, it's kind of annoying, I guess.
Getting called a nickname.
I feel like teachers just learn how to pronounce students' names properly.
Yeah, because like when you mispronounce a name, their pride like goes down and stuff, like the little name, I guess. Because like you're saying your name and then they mispronounce it, I'm like, oh, well, good then, like, you know, like, yeah.
I find it very difficult when teachers try to pronounce my last name and they say it wrong. It's kind of just embarrassing. Like, I should be proud of my last name, but it's also very hard to, like, when there's like roles getting called and, you know, there's like a substitute teacher and they pronounce your last name wrong and then like the whole class kind of, you know, makes a laugh about it. It's just embarrassing.
I find that it's easier, I know how that sounds, but it's easier to shorten my name so people can say it and it's less uncomfortable for them and me. I think it's, I get embarrassed that people can't say my name. It sounds silly, but yeah, because it makes it awkward and then like I kind of stutter and yeah, it's uncomfortable, I think.
Most people in my whānau have Māori names. Yeah, same thing, shorten it, nicknames. Just makes it easier for, well, makes, saves the awkwardness for them, really.
Yeah, my little sister too, she calls herself Ru and her name is Rupine. It's not a long name, but yeah, still.
My last name comes from my koro, and my great koro was from the Children of the Mist. From Tuhoi, so my last name is pretty special and I think I should carry it with great mana, but it's kind of hard to for people to understand that in a way. But I don't know, I guess pronouncing it properly is a struggle, but the effort is would be appreciated.
Ah, come in, have a seat. So, what's your name?
Hineraukatauri.
Sorry, could you say that again?
Hineraukatauri.
Hineraukatauri. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
So, what brings you to my office on the first day?
I had an argument with Miss Campbell, sir.
Really? Already? Not even at the end of period one.
She refused to try and say my name properly, sir.
Were you rude to her?
Yes, but only after she was rude to me.
Well, she's free this period, so I can call her and go head off to period two. Come in, Betty, have a seat.
I assume this is about Hineraukatauri?
It's Hineraukatauri, Betty.
Whatever, her name is too hard. She was very rude to me, that little minx.
I beg your pardon. She is a brand new student to our school. I'm shocked at your attitude, Miss Campbell. What exactly did you say to her?
I said exactly what I told you. Your name is too hard for me, and I asked if I could call her by her middle name, Katrina. She was very disrespectful. Surely that is a reasonable request.
Oh, good grief, Betty. Again? This is not the first time you try to call a student by their middle name because you can't be bothered to learn their Māori name.
You know how busy we are. When am I supposed to find the time to learn how to speak Māori?
I'm not asking you to become a fluent Māori speaker. I do, however, expect you to make an effort to learn to pronounce Māori names and words. You know what? Thank you. You've just highlighted the need for us to conduct some vital professional development in this area. We'll be starting next week.
Really? Are you prioritizing this?
Yes, I am.
Well, we'll see how the rest of the staff respond. I'm sure, like me, they'll agree there are other things more important.
We are not just here to fill kids' heads full of information, Miss Campbell. We're here to teach them to become good people and treat each other with kindness and respect. How on earth can we think they'll learn that when we aren't modelling positive behaviour?
Pōrari Māori tātai rengarenga! Ahi a ia!
Where the hell is that voice coming from? Who is that? Why can't I see you? Are you a kēhua?
Kēhua? E ki rā kōreo e pai ki tēnā pū. He kaitiaki kēhua.
Kaitiaki? That's like a guardian, eh?
Ai, koe tō kaitiaki, ne?
Whoa. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little freaked out. But for some reason, I feel okay.
Ai, koe mata ko mai. Ko ai kope, kope ko ai. Kei te rere o ki to toki roto I ake.
So, you're me, and I'm you. Whoa, that's pretty cool. Sorry, I don't speak much Māori. I only learnt a little bit at primary.
Mā ki tō e reno Māori e whakahoki ki ake.
Oh my god. People are gonna think I'm crazy talking to myself. Maybe you should go.
Kaore! Kei konei e hei te aki akwe. Kore ai hoki tai noa ki te waka paikwe I te mohiotanga me te kaha kia tuka I tēnei ahuri.
I don't even believe in all this stuff. Mum and Dad are gonna freak.
Hey, Spunky. Who are you talking to?
No one.
Whatever. I heard you.
Whatever. Anyway, who are you calling Spunky?
You? I don't care that you talk to yourself. You're still hot. I like crazy chicks.
Give it up, mate. It's never gonna happen.
Q-Wick, you'll fall for my charm and boyish good looks one day.
Ooh, whatever. Maybe when you get a facelift.
Ooh, that cuts deep, girl.
Oh. Get out, man! You're so embarrassing!
Is it Hannah?
Oh! That's it, Dick! Piss off!
I bid thee farewell, my beautiful flower.
Growing up, I was confused because my dad would be called by his Pākehā name instead of his, you know, birth name. And I guess it was just confusing to me why people couldn't just say his, like, real name. Like his, I don't know, his mates even just called him by a, like, Pākehā name, and I just didn't get it. And even my brother, he actually shortened his name down so it's more Pākehā, like easier to say, like sort of thing. And then even my nephew used to use his middle name instead of his actual name because he was worried people wouldn't be able to say his real name correctly. And I just feel like that impacts people, like they're not able to show who they really are, like with their name, because it's just, yeah, it's important to be able to, like, know who you are and let everyone else know who you are. And that you've got roots to these, like, you've got
Māori roots and stuff, but you're worried that people don't know. Like, I mean, don't know how to say your name properly. Like in my dad's case, it's because he grew up in a time where it wasn't okay to use your Māori name. Like in schools, and like you had to have a Pākehā name because the teachers just wouldn't like call your name if, you know, if it was a Māori name, whatever.
Office period one.
You what? You are kidding me. Explain the thing.
Did I hear that right?
Wait, just listen.
Go on then.
My teacher, Miss Campbell, couldn't pronounce my name.
And? Heaps of people can't say your name at first.
Then I offered to help her and she said she didn't have time to learn my name and asked if she could call me Katrina.
Is this true, babe?
Every word, Mum. Then I called her an upoko kōrua and she said it was principal.
You called her a what? What the hell does that even mean?
It means hooked head.
It does.
If you don't know what it means, why did you call her that?
She told me.
She? The teacher?
No! My great-great-great-grandmother, the one I got my name from.
Wait, what? What do you mean?
She said that word, then I did.
Baby, you're scaring me. I don't understand.
She talks to me. I first heard her when I was talking to Miss Campbell. Then we had a conversation at the bus stop.
A conversation? At the bus stop? That's bonkers.
Gary, stop. We need to listen to her.
I blame the internet, you know, filling her head with all this crap. What a load of nonsense.
Hold on. How did you come up with that name?
What name?
Who named you, moron? Hineraukatauri?
It just came to me.
Really? It just came to you?
Okay. I thought I heard a voice.
A voice of an almighty woman, right? There she goes again! Oh God, Dad, really? Her, Nanny Hineraukatauri. Is she here, babe? Yep, I can hear
her. Can you see her?
No. Oh, my darling! You have the gift! Well, this is the only gift I'm not happy about getting. You know, you're not the only one in the family that can talk to our tupuna.
There's someone else?
Yes, your grandmother. She was about your age when she first heard them.
Are you two for real? This cannot be happening. You two are taking the piss, eh?
It's okay. This is more normal than you think. It's a blessing.
Kōrero e moko kōrero.
Kōrero e moko kōrero.
What?
That's what she just said.
I'm calling your name right now. You two need to talk.
He ngā kai tisikaha tō e moko.
Ngā kai tisikaha. Confidence, steadfastness, commitment, dedication. Aw, thanks, Kui. That's very kind.
Ai, ko koe tēnā. Kei te wara haere koe ki aru ni e moko. He mea pai tēnā.
If you don't mind, Kui, I'm not going to tell anyone else I can hear you. I don't want people to think I'm pōrangi.
Koe nā e moko, pōrangi! Kei te ako koe I tō reo, kā re roa ka matatau koe.
Matatau. To know well, be proficient, expert at, competent, fluent. Me, matatau. You think?
Ai, kei a koe te kaha. Kei roto tō reo I tō whatsumanawa.
You watch, Kui. I'm going to go hard in my Māori class. I'm going to get as much out of my kaiako as possible. I want to understand every word that you say to me.
Ka mau te wehi, aha kua te aha kei konei e hei tautoko I a Kui.
Tautoko. To support, prop up, verify, advocate, accept, agree. Aw, thanks, Kui. I'm so glad you're here.
Mā, kei te ahari kua hoki au e moko.
Kia ora Hineraukatauri.
Kia ora nē.
Kia ora kōrua.
Kia ora hine māia. Kōrua te wā.
Āna, tēnō roa.
Wait, what? Nanny, can you hear her too?
Yes, moko, I can. She came to me when I was about your age too.
Really? Were you scared, Nan?
At first, yes. But I got used to having her around. And eventually, I really liked having her around. I missed her when she left.
I'm starting to like having her around too.
Oh, kei konei e moko rua e aku moko puna.
Did she teach you Māori too, Nan?
Yes, moko, she did. But times were different when I was a girl. You weren't allowed to speak Māori at school. And practicing your language in tikanga was heavily frowned upon.
Really, Nan? Why?
They wanted us to be like mellow puffs, brown on the outside and white on the inside. Times were hard.
I'm going to be fluent, Nan. You watch. Ko au kōrero pai, au matata.
Ko koe au mai moko o kia rua tia, ki te tōru koe me he mana teitei.
Ai, Māori ka e moko. You go and get it. I love your tenacity.
Thank you, Nan.
Maranga, ake About making an effort to do something that makes these kids feel valued. These kids' names mean a lot to them. And if you don't try, they'll think you don't care about them as a person.
I care. I'm up until 10 p.m. marking their damn work. That's how much I care.
Yes, but if you have mutual respect, then the work you're marking will have more effort put into it. Because they'll want to please you. Because, well, they'll like you.
Educational psychologists now, are we?
Well, I'd rather be an educational psychologist than a brick wall, because I feel like I'm talking to one right now.
Thank you!
Oh,
Hineraukatauri. 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 Hineraukatauri.
Kia kaha, Betty.
Hineraukatauri. Hineraukatauri.
Hineraukatauri. Hineraukatauri. I think I've got it. Hineraukatauri. Hineraukatauri? I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. That's why I want you to know I'm starting with the man in the mirror. I'm asking him to make a change. No message could have been any clearer. If you wanna make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and make a change.
This was in primary, actually, and because we had this old male principal, he said my name's like pretty much different to everyone else how they say my name. I think he called me Waikato Moana, even though that's not my name, but I had just let that slide though. So yeah, I don't know. It just feels weird, and it's like they're not making enough effort to actually say it properly. Actually, all my friends kind of just call me Wai now, because it's more easier for them. Well, it's just stuck with me, pretty much. I don't mind it, but it'll be nice for everyone to like call me by my full name, pretty much. But yeah. Well, with my name, because I'm one of the only ones in my family with a Māori name. So it's only me and two of my cousins, one of my cousins actually, with a Māori name. Everyone else is like just English, pretty much. And like about weird being one of the only ones with a Māori name in the family. But yeah.
All right. Rhonda Smith. Anthony White. Raymond Jones.
What's up, miss?
Yes, would be a more appropriate response.
Yes,
ma'am. Shayla Williams.
Present.
Derek Potts.
Yes, m'lady.
Hineraukatauri. Hineraukatauri.
Here, miss.
All right, off you go. Have a good day and behave.
Have a beautiful day, m'lady.
Miss. Can I talk to you, please?
Certainly.
Miss, you said my name right.
Did I? Oh, I'm so pleased.
Me too, miss. But what changed?
Let's just say I had a little bit of help.
From who?
From her. She came to me in my dream and, well, showed me a very valuable lesson.
Miss, do you know who that is?
I know she's the same name as you.
Miss, that's my great-great-great-grandmother. I'm named after her.
Things are gonna be different from here on in, Hineraukatauri.
You have no idea how happy I am to hear that.
Now off you go or you're gonna be late.
Tēnā koe e koe.
Tēnā koe e moko. E koe e muti taku aroha mōru. E noho rā.
Haere rā e koe.
Whakatū wherahea mai ngā tata o te awairoe. Whakina mai, whakina mai.
Ko Wai'o, I am years and places,
moments and people intertwined, where X and Y collide, I equal product. Product of history, I must be destiny. Two sides of a coin ingrained in my palmistry. Genetic diaries twisted into one story. My thread that is being stitched into the tapestry of our history. My ancestry stitched into mountain ridges and sewn into this earth. Tangata whenua. Papatūānuku sang and we listened. Guided by her hand, we became one with the land. Seed sown in Rangiatea. Our reo, the umbilical cord that connects us to this whenua. Our whakapapa, song lines in the chorus. Our names, drum beats in the heartbeats of Aotearoa, New Zealand. A trophy to be mounted on the wall, the tapestry of my ancestry put behind glass, because history was dead in the eyes of the missionaries. Eyes full of hunger for the taonga of our land, picking and choosing which pieces of our history were worth consuming. Our body, battered and bruised, fires deracinates our roots, butchered and priced, put up for auction, sold to the highest bidder. Prized possessions, our children, force-fed silence, their tongue ripped from their lips, the bite of the cane was to swallow the pain. The scars of untold stories are the holes in our tapestry. Papatūānuku gagged and muffled, her song singing to the blood in their veins. Our veins, ko au, ko te awa, ko au, flowing from one generation to the next. My ancestors stand behind me. My name, the faces I see when I look in the mirror. Hers before her, before her. I am, I am, I am. So when you say my name is a mouthful, it's not your place. It's not for you to pick and choose which pieces of me are digestible. It's not for me to stand in silence and swallow your shame. My ancestors fought yesterday so I could fight for tomorrow. Not one more acre will be taken. Not one more acre of my identity. So when you pronounce my name, you acknowledge my tūpuna. You acknowledge the history between us. Our history, our shared story, my pepeha. This land and its story is woven into the fabric of my genetics. The kākahu I wear, the name I bear. Ko te kahariki, te kahu waitai, aho.
Oh, Anthony Bongwa! Tēnei kaupapa whakahirahira. Tei ngaingoa, wātā tēnei tamariki Māori, kua roa, e whakahuatia kinoti ana. Tō mātou nei hiehia, te whakātu atu ki te ao, nāenei me huri te tai. Kua roa tēnei āhuatanga, i nāenei me panu. Oia rā, te karere. Ki te mare, nā reira, tēnā rau atu koutou i runga anō rā i tā koutou kaha koutoku i tēnei kaupapa i tēnei, tēnei pōmi. Tēnā no tātou. This kaupapa has been brewing for quite some time now. And about 6 years ago, we were taking a group through to Parihaka for the reconciliation between the crowd and the people of Parihaka. When we stopped them in the night before we went to Parihaka to Waiokura Marae, which we have a very, very close connection to, right back to the time when Rāwhiti Gibson was teaching us at school, and we'd go there twice a year. And when we went to the marae that night, there was a kaumātua who welcomed us on. And he was talking about our kuia, my Auntie Joseph. And Auntie Jo, I've always known as Auntie Jo. Okay, she is a beautiful, beautiful human, has invested her whole life into her whānau, her iwi, her hapū, her marae, and my whole life, all I've known was that her name was Joseph. This kaumātua gets up, and when he's talking on the pipe, he's referring to Auntie Jo as Hine Waito. And I looked at Auntie Jo's daughter, Bonita, and looked there, and she just looks at me and goes, he told the story of when she was at school. The teacher couldn't say her name properly. So said, "Can I call you Joseph?" And if you were a Māori child in school at that time, you didn't argue with the teacher. So what happened at that point, your whole life, no one was Jason. And if we think this is an isolated incident, it's not. It's been happening generation upon generation upon generation upon generation upon generation. It happens now in schools. We get kids shortening their names or using an English. Some kids use their middle name. Some kids, for example, they're waiting. Te awatea, sometimes they just ask to be called T because they don't want to be able to experience that embarrassment of every time someone's saying their name incorrectly. Does it have a psychological impact on you? Of course it does. So it's happened for a long, long time, and it's more than just something small. A lot of people don't understand. But heaps of these guys do, and heaps of you do. Because there's heaps of people on this whare this evening that have experienced this. So I want to mihi to you for your support of our rangatahi. And when we engage in this kaupapa, I never, not for one second, had any doubt in their ability to be able to cover this kaupapa. I know, I see these kids every day. They are extremely multi-talented, but sometimes you don't get to see what they've got to give you. And a lot of what you've seen tonight is them just expressing themselves in the way that, with their skills, with their talents, with their abilities. And, that's part of it. ko whakapau kaha koe te mō tēnei kaupapa. Mai I te timatanga, tau mai, tēnei wā. Kua kawea e koutou tēnei kōrua ki tō tātou hapua. Te kaupapa rangatika. Tō koutou rangatika. Kanui takumiri aloha ki a koutou katoa. Are just these exceptional young people, and there's just so many people around. I'm not gonna, I could go through a massive book list, but you'll be here till midnight, so wait. But I just thank you to you, thank you to all you beautiful rangatahi and everyone who supported, right from the kura, the stage and tech crew, everyone. Nei rā a mihi kā rere atu ki a koutou. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou sako.
Māori, you guide us, you lead us, you help us tell the stories that need to be told, like this one. He calling on the heroes.
Ah!
a relief that it got to my name on the vault, and they kind of couldn't say it. They tried, and they're like two, and then they got to the R's and they couldn't roll them or something, and so they just decided to call me TK for the rest of the lesson.
Instead of trying to learn our name or look at the paper, he just called us the Maori girls and everyone went silent instead. Like, the way he said it was like being Maori was bad.
Yeah.
And that we were just being obnoxious.
That we were like just Maori girls?
Yeah. Like, I'm proud to be Maori, but
yeah,
at least say our names.